I don't mind admitting the last place I expected to finish up was as an exhibit in the Chamber of Horrors. And not even at the main HQ, but in Blackpool, if you please. Nowhere to be found on my long list of desirable places to spend the weekend. And yet, not so very long ago, I had a fair claim to be the most popular man in London. Stephen Ward, your friendly osteopath, I can fix your lower back for you. Also known for high-class portraiture. And you'll find out that's not all I do. Winston Churchill, Ava Gardner, different contours, same predicament. Gandhi was another regular, called me his preferred medicament. I invented a new way of life, some might call it unconventional. All that stuffy post-war Englishness, I liked something more consensual. You'll be wondering what I'm doing here, stuck between Hitler and the acid bath murderer. Let me warn you, it's the consequence. If you get up the nose of the establishment, if you give them what they're looking for, they'll be grateful. Oh, they'll be awfully nice. But if you should step across the line, you'll become a human sacrifice. Friends could never understand the girls who caught my eye. Shop girls, models, working girls, I'd have them all come by. Strange behavior, you may think, but tolerance is blind. All I ever cared about was simply being kind. I tried marriage, didn't go for it. I liked freedom and diversity, mixed with all sorts, tarts and royalty, and of course the young and beautiful portraits of the Duke of Edinburgh. Jolly threesomes in Belgravia, weekends in some stately country house with assorted misbehavior. All this was my life. Limitless delights. All the girls and all the parties of the amazing nights. Self-indulgence is permissible, but one day you'll have to pay the price. I suppose I stepped across the line and became a human sacrifice. They will bring you down unless your heart's as cold as ice. Nothing they like better than a human sacrifice. No matter how experienced or sophisticated you are, you never see it coming, do you? I mean, when I stepped into Murray's Club in Beak Street that wet and murky Tuesday, why should it have been any different from the dozens of other evenings I'd whiled away there?